chat. Because of some Kippur, it's Hardcore Nerdcore Wrestling with just me. Ernie is observing Yom Kippur, so you know, he is not going to be able to do commentary tonight, so it's just me flying solo. It's going to be quite the show, though, because we got a lot of show to get through, and yeah, despite the fact that we kind of took the first week of the month off, we're still going to be building up to something pretty big. Our end of the year pay-per-view, Smack to School, already had its first match tournament last week, where let's see, let me just double check the card we got here. Yeah, where Sonic versus Bayonetta. It's a real Sega showdown for the 3000 Brigade Championship. And we're also going to be determining a couple others right here, because the number one contendership will be, our main event tonight is Jonesy Spencerson. We'll be taking on the first of three opponents to be the number one contender at Smack to School. Now, for that, I would like to start off with a very serious announcement, because my freedom of speech has been curtailed very much. I am currently kicked off of Facebook because I didn't want, because I said something bad about, like, Ron DeSantis and how he should be run over, which is an objectively true fact, really. Because, like, fuck that douchebag. Okay, cool. Just transferring that, and so for our first match tonight, Ron DeSantis will be facing a mystery car-based opponent. Who knows what it'll be, but I am getting, hold on, that's the Discord view. I am getting the display ready, so bear with me for a second, because usually also Ernie likes to run interference when I do these things. So, hold on. Is it, why is match text not loading? That's kind of sus. So, our first match for tonight is Ron DeSantis versus a mysterious car-based opponent. Hold on. Background opacity. Back. Black background. Alright, well, looks like that's not working right now. So, hold on. Let me just do one quick thing here. Again, usually I have Ernie running interference for me. Either way, so again, that's the downside of going solo. So yes, Ron DeSantis, or rather Zombie Ron DeSantis, who is the governor of Florida. Hopefully he won't be for very long, either due to, you know, other reasons. But yeah, it looks, and we are also blowing our non-canonical spot on this one, so let's cut to the ring right now. There's Ron DeSantis, a little bitch. Fuck him. We don't need you. Go to hell. Wait, who is this? Oh my god, is it Optimus Prime? Head of the Autobots? Wow, if there's a car who is going to be running over... I mean, honestly, it would be an honor to be run over by such a noble car as... as Optimus Prime. I mean, wow. Prime starting off strong with a few elbow drops. Ronda Santos tries to get a hit in, but Optimus Prime is just too much. Oh, and looks like it starts with an Irish Whip, and Ronda Santos being the little bitch he is with the drop, unfortunately. Unlocking a couple shoulder checks, but Ron DeSantis, and another whiff from Ron DeSantis, just like he's been whiffing the COVID-19 protocols, all in the name of a bullshit culture war. Nice elbow from back from Optimus Prime. Ooh, but a dirty kick in the groin from DeSantis. There goes Ron DeSantis out of the ring. Optimus Prime using this time to rest up a bit. Oh, I don't think he's going to get, Ronnie isn't going to get any fair treatment. This ain't Newsmax. And a big boot from Optimus Prime. And a butt slam from Optimus Prime. A near fall. One, and Ronnie goes flying two, out of the ring. Optimus three, Prime. Four. Oh, I don't know how you're going to take on the Autobot Big Man. Windmill fist from Optimus Prime. And into the ropes he goes. And a gorilla press, which does make sense because in the Beast Wars cartoon, which I probably watched the most of, Optimus Prime was a gorilla, and a flying top elbow off the top rope.
Give up.
With the windmill slam off the top rope, and a diving elbow right into the back. Not even Fidel Castro would be this dirty to Ron DeSantis. Oh, Ron can't even have any time to recover because Optimus Prime, not being a little bitch like Ron DeSantis, recovers right away and, ow! Choke slam, drag him to the middle of the ring.
One, two, three!
And Optimus Prime, the winner. Man, Ron DeSantis really got run over there. Right, and we are back to camera view. There we go. Okay, like I said, it's going to take a little bit of time to get used to switching. Wow, what a hell of a match. Turns out Ron DeSantis made it legal to run over people with your car if they're protesters. Now, of course, that only works with people he disagrees with, so go fuck yourself. Anyway, Optimus Prime, of course, obviously the winner. Up next, we have a proper barn burner of a match. The tag team of the Health and Well-Beings versus the Power Couple. Now, the Health and Well-Beings, the team of the male Wii Fit trainer and Dino Hunter MD, Derek Maslow, it's really just a combination of two competitors who can put on a hell of a five-star match. I mean, you know, you got male Wii Fit trainer who won the 3KB canonization match. You have Derek Maslow who, you know, cannot leave a match without giving less than a five-star effort. So I'm very excited to see what happens next. And up against them are a king and a queen. That is to say, King Bowser and Queen Boo. I mean, honestly, I don't know what's going to happen. It's going to be a great match. We're definitely looking into some potential number one competitors. So keep your eyes peeled, folks. It is going to be a hell of a match tonight. So we're going to cut it over to the ring. And there's Derek Maslow 3000 versus Queen Vu, representing the 3000 Brigade Division, and that, you know, that's always a fun match. That's always a fun division to keep your eyes on. Up in the ring first is Derek Maslow versus Male Bowser, King of the Koopas. A little bit of a tough strength, but Male Bowser ultimately winning the battle.
Uh-oh,
looks like a little combat outside of the ring. This could be
11.
Due to count out. You know, we fit trainer getting tagged in. Very smart to help him with our beams, trying to keep Male Bowser to the corner. And in comes Queen Vu. Now, while she doesn't lack the power, she is that boss bitch who will fuck up all the shit. Ooh, man, we fit trainer taking that one. And a body slam from Queen Boo. Maslow taking his time to get in here. He knows that Male Wee Fit Trainer handles it. Male Wee Fit Trainer is very practiced in yoga. So obviously, you know, he's not one to stretch it out.
Three, four, five, six.
Ooh, and right in the donger. But of course, the health and well-beings have the positional advantage. Queen Boo making her way to the, making her way to her partner, Male Bowser, who hits Derek Maslow with a lariat. Male Bowser reversing the Irish whip, really showing off his power. Reverse that hold.
Yeah.
And an assisted power bomb from the health and well beings. Both teams still very fresh, so neither of them are really concerned when you know, when one of their partners in trouble. Trainer really showing off his strong ground game. And you really need to know how to manipulate your opponent's strength if you are just not, if you lack the power as Bowser does. And now granted, Male Wee Fit Trainer is in shape, but I mean, he is nothing compared to the King of the Koopas. Back and forth, Queen Boo. Oh ho ho! And a skull crushing finale.
One, two.
But it's only good for a two count. Side, Bowser's gonna have to come quite a long ways. And Derek Maslow's tagged in. Double drop kick from the power couple. Trainer really putting on every hold on Male Bowser, but Bowser has this muscle to power out of it. And now Queen Boo comes in to serve him with a double drop kick. Uh-oh. We go for a gorilla press. By Queen Boo. The power couple really knows how to look out for each other. Eric Maslow and Queen Boo is the man. But that looks like it's a rope break. Looking at the record of Queen Boo, she has had plenty of five-star matches herself. So we're really looking at some five-star royalty here in the ring. Ooh, and a nice play kick. Male Wii Fit Trainer. And off the top rope for Queen Boo. And that's a rope break. And off the turnbuckle, Derek Maslow. He goes out of the ring.
He's
trying to rest, but there's no time. Because in comes Bale Bowser. Now, this is some real textbook stuff we got going on here, because Thousand Well Beings have all the technique in the world, but more important than anything in a tag team match, they got their backs. Bowser with a Rainmaker. And Queen Boo with a pile driver on Derek Maslow. Now Bowser to belly to back. Oh, and Male Wii Fit Trainer is dazed. Tilt the World Slam on Queen Boo. Can they capitalize? But no, Queen Boo retaliates. With a Nut Buster and a Hurricanrana. And out she goes. I accidentally set it for elimination rules. So it's a 2-on-1 match. Great. We've seen how badly that these 2-on-1 matches can go, how they can snowball. And that's a tap out from Male Bowser.
Thank you.
mean, obviously, we had the king and the queen of the five-star in the ring. And that's a five-star match. Oh, my God. What a hell of a way to properly start off tonight's match. Up next. Let me just update the health and well-being. They're definitely number one contenders for, or they're definitely in the running to face the Mario Bros. Next week at, at Smack to School, which is the 30th, not the 23rd like I have on my notes. Right, up next, we got some big men smacking meat. And of course, we got the enforcer of... No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, we got some masked muscle going on as we have Meowsles, the enforcer of the fiercest furs, versus the reader of emails and the bestest of artists, Abyssy Strongbad. And we're gonna cut to the ring right now. I don't know why they named him Mr. Meowsles, but sure, it works for me. Of course, we got Strong Bad. Yeah. Ooh, that's pretty even on the test of strength there. Now, Meowsles had a bit strong offense early, but, ooh. The Strong Bad is about to get that babyface shine with those drop kicks. Oh, that was a close one. But it's only a near fall, though. Strong Bad's still in it.
Shoot. Yeah.
5 minutes gone.
Strong Bad with the Trogdor screw.
Yeah.
Meowsles breaks out of that right away. And another near fall for Strong Bad. Strong Bad still has that fighting spirit. He's still in it. And this one thing I've learned about Strong Bad is that you can never fully count him out.
Great.
Ooh, that could have been a pin for Strong Bad, but it's a break, unfortunately. Oh, and a reversal.
Great.
A break for Strong Bad, but he capitalizes it on right away. What Strong Bad needs to start doing is conserving his energy. and a crucifix pile driver. Gives the win to Meowsles. That was a fairly quick match. I'm surprised. Strong Bad looks like he had it in there. Okay, and now our last match before the break is the Undercard Belts Championship. Now, Red Link, who has been also been the 3000 Brigade Championship, is about to face off against the rest of Red, who are this is essentially his jumping in. And up next will be a mystery opponent of the Red that I am going to be pulling out of my ass. Let's see who it is. Oh, and it's the Scout!
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a pretty big deal with the stock to the shelf. So love a whole rain apart from the south side. I use my legs because I never had a ride. Tried going to the major leagues, but they said they didn't have a place for me.
And our champ, undercard champion, Red Link.
Hallelujah!
Ooh. Now the thing is that while Scout is considered the weakest, I believe they're going up from most to least toughest. They do want some form, but Scout, of course, being the speedster he is, was the first to get in there. Ooh.
One.
Nope, the Scout with the small pack roll up. Now, the Scout comes fast and furious, but we do know that Red Link's ground game is nothing to sneeze at. So the thing is, will he be able to capitalize on it as we continue? And a nice DDT from the Scout. Donger. Scout taking no chances. Going all out on this one. But Red Link knows to spank the boy when it's time. Red Link's starting to get a little winded. The Scout fighting dirty like he did on the streets of Boston. And listen, you gotta have that same intensity if you want to take away the championship. And out he goes, Red Link taking his time to recover a little bit. Nice reversal there from Red Link. And while Red Link has been focusing on the Scout's legs, Scout hasn't slowed down a bit.
Great.
Scout calling for the crowd. What a gut-wrench suplex from Red Link. Buys him a little bit more time.
One, two. Give up.
And another DDT from the Scout.
Three.
Ooh, and that's a break. Scout toes barely touching the line. But a sunset flip from Red Link. And another one sends Scout careening out of the ring. And barely enough time to recover. I think we might start to see Scout running out of gas. That's it!
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a pretty big deal with the style of a
champ. And Scout is your new undercard champion. Holy shit, that was a good match. That was a lot of fun. Honestly, you know what? Red Link had a heck of a run, but you just got to give it to our current and future champ, the Scout. So we're going to take a little break, and on the other side of that break, we are going to have the Norm McDonald Championship Charity Match. Well, it's not the championship charity match. It's just the Norm McDonald Memorial Match. So, I hope to see you there on the other side of this break. Let me just type in some shit very quickly. There we go. And away I go. Probably back. Oh, shit. I just realized I was muted. Well, fuck. Anyway, this is in honor of Norm MacDonald. Dinoff Suits looks like Burt Reynolds, Kirk Ferguson, which should be obvious. I fucked up bad.
Hey y'all, Scott.
Ooh, that was another big smackaroonie. And Teen Offshoots goes down. Gets him in a leg lock, but not for long. Students gets the best of that suplex.
Great.
An attitude adjustment. Kirk Ferguson working the legs.
Give up.
Oh, and it looks like Dean Off Students managed to reverse that. Kirk Ferguson tries, he might. Isn't it quite as beefy as our Deanie lad? It went right in the back of the skull, Kirk Ferguson. But he reverses it with a snapmare. Power bomb
Great.
From Dinoff Students, but they're just too close to that corner.
Great.
You can't do much if you keep rope break. Oh god, and then Turk Ferguson outside of the ring. In the corner, and with the roll up, but only a two count. But Dinoff Students returns with a senton, and that's a near fall for Turd Ferguson. Turd better watch out, or he's gonna end up with a knock against him, and a frog splash. I mean, you know, Dino Off Students actually does own his own wrestling school, and he has been making a lot of strides here in, really trying to build up that profile. And you do that by just having all those wins underneath your belt. So let me just mark that as a win for Dino Off Students. Up next, now, RPG Pals Club as a faction. I've tried to stay together as a strong unit. However, they recently broken up, not for any bad reasons, but for storyline reasons. So if you've been listening as the episodes have been coming out, all the teams went to different, the party broke up and went to different locations. to search out different pieces of a key that would unlock the dragon horn. And because of that, they all kind of split up, and I gave everybody cute little names. Ooh, okay, this is gonna be a fun one. So, up next we have a match of the Punch Beef Himbo Squad, which is Oi and Koyos, versus the team Navinia and Kier, who have been known as the Fancy Team. So we are going to start that up, and then wait, hold on. I might have set it to elimination match again. I didn't want to set it to elimination again. Elimination is off. There we go. Come on. All right, let's go. There we go. Okay. No, I'm sorry. I just thought Oi looked like Kier. I accidentally skipped the intros. Now, Oi and Navinia are formerly members of the RPG Pals Club band, but they're fighting against each other. Now, this is really more of a friendly match trying to build themselves up as a unit. It's going to be very interesting to see how they turn on each other, or how they use their various skills against each other. Oi fending off the Fancy Team. Kier is trying to end this as soon as possible because he is pulling double duty tonight as the number one contender for facing off against Jonesy Spencerson. Nope, not phased at all. A lot of back and forth, but finally comes down to Snapmare. Koyos is working his way back to his team's ride. And Oil Man just put her down for a one.
5 minutes gone.
Uh-oh. Being it with the leg lock on Oi, it's interesting to see how these team dynamics break up. Now, Koyos is no stranger to teamwork, as he is, or was, the former champion of Trios champion, part of the Lizard People. And in comes Koyos. And a gator splash on a Kier. And another big boot. Koyos really working over Kier, who wisely tagged in for Navinia. Oh, and Kier, man, to save Navinia. Norris tags in Oi, but Nathania. Jerry Bolt is fending off both of them. Here seem to be going at this way more serious than we would have liked. Gonna get in, and he beats the count. No, and that's a two count. Of course, Oi and Nathania have been banned from ever working together as a team after their loss at the Incel Games, I believe. Oh, and that was a painful back-breaking piledriver. And here breaking up the fight. Just the power bomb. Ooh, but a nice gut red suplex from here, even things up. Broken up at two. And a tiger suplex from here. All right, he's tagging up into the venue, and they give him a double drop kick. And a tiger driver, but it's only a two count. And a stone cold stunner from Oi. And Oi is with an STF. Good luck when you both have former partners treat each other like that. That was a great match. There's a lot of great matches going on tonight. Let's see. And that's a win for the Punch Beef Himbo Squad. So, you know, who knows? Maybe this will give them a little more, how do you say, little more success in the tag team rounds. You know, we're not quite familiar with the trios yet, so who knows? Who knows how that's going to shake out? And I'm just going to go with Kier. Lost in that column. Nope, that's not right. Worse is right, and Vang is also losing one that time. So, all right, and now Sahoni at Sahoni underscore stuff has a new game coming out called The Exceptionals. I need to make sure I'm centered like here. I just need to tell my good thing over a little bit. There we go. Okay, that way I'm more in line. Oh, God, my fucking was a mess. Anyway, yeah, so, and so we're going to give him a match tonight. Let me just find Dodger. Yeah, actually, we did play it on the show live, right? So, and up next, he's facing someone who very tangentially, also has a game coming out. So we're going to cut it to the ring. Wait, is that Waluigi? Never technically affiliated with Wario, but yeah, WarioWare Get It Together is out now on the Nintendo Switch. No invitation to the game of beatings. This is the ultimate slap in the face. I'm angry deeply. They call me up if they need a fiddle. That's how they treat me. They get a Jigglypuff and a Gambus. Sunset flip from Dodger, followed up by a DDT. And of course, that we gave UV the match off because out comes Waluigi, and well, we've received some complaints. Waluigi with the big one. But a nice suplex from Dodger will keep Waluigi in check. Waluigi reverses and Dodger goes fly. Oh no! Waluigi's got a bat.
Two, three.
Swing and a miss. That whip looks like it goes wrong for Dodger.
Give up.
Waluigi might be the one in control here.
Give up. Come on.
Another swing in DDT from Dodger. A lot of kicking going on, I noticed. This is like a chorus line. And a hurricane wanted out of Dodger. And Dodger slides into home.
Give up.
But that leaves him open for a leg lock from Waluigi. Thank you. song from the Wolf Boy. And a sunset flip. Can we see this as a reversal of Dodger's fortune? Ooh. He's gotta get out of that turnbuckle first. Oh, I do not like the noise of that thumping sound.
10 minutes back.
Sunflip, the Dodger's using that time to recover inside the ring. Nice uppercut from Waluigi. He's just toying with Dodger at this point. That's a two count. And a big boot from Waluigi. Goes right back into Kier, but the falling Tiger suplex. And both feet to the face. Will this do it? Oh, and it's only a near fall. Waluigi says, I got a foot, and Dodger replies with, I got two, bitch. Uh-oh. Could this be Waluigi going in for the pin? Facebreaker. Thankfully, the Waluigi hasn't busted out the fork. Those are vicious punches for such a scrawny guy. Dodger really needs to recover if he expects to win this time. Dodger stunned. Slept over for a big one. And eye poke to the eyes. He's putting his educated feet to good use. And the Shining Wizard from Waluigi.
One, two.
Oh, that's a near fall for Dodger. It's only a near fall. Dodger's still in it. Right into the crotch. Waluigi doing some posing instead of pinning. But that could give Dodger the opportunity he needs.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Right, and Dodger throws Waluigi back in the ring. Any second Waluigi spends outside of the ring increases the chances he's going to get something naughty. That looks like he got some air off that one. And another one. Could be the opening Waluigi needs. But instead, he's just toying with Dodger. Peppering him with all these little punches. It's another near fall. Dodger's still in it. And a coup de la. And it has a turnbuckle. Dodger barely hanging in there. With a shoot of the face. And another shoot of the face. Tiger suplex. And out comes the fork. The fact that Waluigi went this long proves just how ruthless he's being. Now Dodger's pushing it to the limits. Running bulldog. Two count. And another running bulldog. We're at the 30-minute mark. Neither man giving up. That's a stun, a reversal, and a neckbreaker. Ooh, and Dodger plays him in the middle of the ring. Uh-oh. Waluigi reverses that suplex. And this could be the last days of Dodger. Thank you. two count. That's a rope break. This could be, oh no, and Waluigi wins by count out.
So I've been sitting in this multi-million dollar mansion that I live in, sipping some exquisite wine, lobster tail fish out the kitchen. But I've been thinking I ain't satisfied with all the riches. Things are different. I feel a part of me.
And, but that was a five-star match. I mean, that was a great one. You can pick up Dodgers game, The Exceptionals, at Bramble Wolf Games. Okay, let's mark that down on the result card. That was a cheap one. That was a cheap win, though, not gonna lie. And last but not least, the number one contendership match. So this is how these matches are gonna work. Is that Jonesy Spencerson will go up against three opponents, and if he manages to beat all three, then he is the number one contender. But if any of them beat him, then they face the next person in the gauntlet. So we are going to see Jonesy Spencerson. And we did say his first match was up against Kier, since it is a robot man. And this is Jonesy looking to fight robots to prepare him for Would You Rather Bot. He has had a lot of great runs in the past, but let's see if his luck can hold out.
Hey, let's go to the status quo. It's all that you need to know. Music and news, you're the game news coming at your stereo.
And starting out not so well with Kier leading a strong offense against winning the first test of strength. But of course you can't out Jonesy Spencerson with his use of the basics. Ooh, and that test breaks even. Oh, and he gets him in the surfboard. Kier bringing that almost right away. He's still got a long time to go. To avoid some of Kier's offense, which is very good, because Kier, as a Warforged, knows all about war stuff and fighting. And And he probably has all kinds of warlock magic. Ooh, and a reversal.
Great.
But Jonesy manages to reverse it into a leg lock of himself, but here, gets him down on the ground. And another surfboard. Small baggage roll up, but Jonesy kicks out almost right away.
Give up.
Very solid ring awareness from Jonesy, because it looked like he was kind of glitching over the ring apron, but it was Jonesy's legs, not Kier's. Jonesy with another headlock on Kier. But Kier's learning to reverse those. And with the leg lock of his own.
One, two.
Oh, no kicks out of two. Now Kier's starting to break out the big guns. Backbreaker on the knee.
Two.
No, another close one. Leg lock from Kier. Jonesy's got a leg lock on Kier. Count. Ooh, right on his neck.
Give up.
You are seeing two technical experts in the ring right now, but you know the power and ferocity of Would You Rather Bot. Oh, and a pile driver.
One, two.
And it's a near fall. And a tiger suplex out of Kier.
One, two.
No, it's only a two count. Kier the gut run suplex in the late back half of this match. Kier's really pulling out all the stops. But Jonesy is getting gassed. And right in the turnbuckle. Oh, and right to a pin. But it's a near fall. Jonesy's still in it. And another tiger suplex. Jonesy is out of energy right now, but it's a near fall. He still has the fighting spirit. And he gets carried into the abdominal stretch. That's a little bit longer than usual. and that's a break. All right, gut wrench out of Kier. Into a sidewalk slam. Now this is just a matter of stamina. It's not even about strength. And a shoulder tackle from Jonesy. With a nice arm drag. Uh-oh. Is he going for the double suicida? Tilt to a backbreaker. Uh-oh. Break. Nope, that's it. Yes, yeah, breaks. Both men using this time to recover. Oh no! And Kier wins it as our number one contender. Well. But it was a five-star, and another five-star match. You know, again, not as good as not as good as we were hoping. Not the Cinderella story we were hoping for. But you know what? Still, a lot of great wrestling tonight. That is the end of the show. I am going to raid iBolt because I've got a lot of shit to do this weekend, and I am very tired. But he is currently playing Spyro right now, and I don't need to do the freeze frame because A, there's not that many people in the chat, and B, it's just me. So when I end it, I end it. So I put 7. All right. It looks like he's in the middle of an ad break right now, so it's going to be a thing where we're going to be back after these commercials. However, we're going to go right now. So, see you next week, everybody.